wait, don't swipe. I know you're gonna leave. You saw a pencil in the guy's hand and he was like, next, but I'm hoping you will stay. Give me 60 seconds. I'm drawing an eye here, and I believe that if you give me 60 seconds, by the end of it, you're gonna say, holy shit, that came together. So I'm hoping that you will learn to trust the process. Everything looks like shit. When you're an artist, it looks like shit. There's always a beginning. You just gotta trust the process, and it'll all come together in the end. So I'm hoping you stay with me till the end. I know it's getting close, but please stay with me. We're almost there. And hopefully this will come together. And at the end, maybe I earn a new follower. If not, it's cool. I'll just be happy that you gave it 60 seconds. Follow these easy steps to draw a cute little kitty. With a pencil, draw an oval with curved triangle shapes on both sides. Then go over it with ink and draw two circles for the eyes. Each eye is going to have two more circles inside. That's going to be the reflection. The nose should be a small triangle with a W underneath. And don't forget the eyebrows. Draw two more triangles on top and a couple bigger ones on the side. They should be kind of rounded on top. Add the lines on the inside of the ears, and then color in all of the black areas. The body should be a little skinnier up top and thicker on the bottom. Add your legs and paws. Don't forget the toes. Add a couple stripes on the side and this little heart collar, and finish it up with a tail. You can add a couple stripes to it. Erase your guidelines and draw a thicker outline, and it'll look really cool, like a sticker. Thanks for watching. Follow these easy steps to draw a cute little bunny. Start with an egg-shaped head and add a couple of eyes. Parallel to the bottom of the eyes, we're going to make a Y shape. Then we're going to add two circles in each eye for the reflections and the eyebrows. Then under the Y, we're going to make an upside-down V for the cheeks. For the ears, we're going to make these rectangle shapes, and at the bottom, we're going to make them pointy and round it off a little bit on top. The body should be another egg shape with an oval in it. Make the arms overlap, a couple circles for the feet, and we're on to inking. I like to make little squiggly lines to make it look like fur around the outside. If I'm going too fast for you, you can watch a slower version of this on my YouTube channel. There's a link in my bio to all of my social media. I hope this helped with your drawing. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to share with your artist friends. See you next time. When I was 4 or 5, I used to watch my older brother draw this, and I was always amazed how he could make something so simple turn into something so cool and 3D looking. Once you add a little shading on the inside, it really comes together. I always looked up to my older brother. It was him and probably my grandfather that got me into art. I'm way better than him now, though. Suck it, Derek. the cool thing I learned later is if I trace the same outline, I could change it up a little bit. If you change the shading a little, you could turn it into a river. Give it a try. It's super simple, super easy. Anyone could do it, and it turns out pretty cool looking. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to follow for more tips and tricks. I would love to help your son learn how to draw a cat. This time we're going to start with pencil. Start with this oval shape and make these kind of curved triangles on the sides. Next, we're going to go over it in ink and draw a couple circles on the inside for the eyes. Now draw two circles on the inside of each eye. The nose should be a small triangle with a W underneath, and don't forget the eyebrows. draw a couple triangles on top and then two on the sides. They should be rounded towards the top. And then draw the inside of the ears like this. Now all you have to do is color in the black areas.
The body should be pretty easy to follow along.
You don't have to be an artist to be able to do this. All it takes is some practice. I call this the kitty cat challenge. Draw this kitty cat 5 times, start to finish without giving up. Now look at the first one compared to the last one. All it takes is a little practice.
If you like these kind of videos, make sure to like and share with your artist friends. Thanks for watching.
Wait, don't swipe. I know you want to swipe. Give me a chance. Give me 60 seconds. I'm back. I'm the guy that drew the eye. This time I'm working on a cherry, and I'm hoping you'll give me 60 seconds like you did last time. Hopefully you gave me 60 seconds last time. One of the things I've realized about being an artist and just life in general is you have to be persistent. Anything new you start may not look right, like this cherry when I first got started, but you have to be persistent. I wasn't born being able to do things like this. It took me many, many years, and I'm still a work in progress, and I learn new things every day, but I'm getting better. You just have to be persistent and grind it out, and trust that everything will come together. Anyways, hopefully you guys like this quick cherry, and maybe I get a follow out of you. If not, thank you for giving me 60 seconds. See you guys. Okay, still too hard. Follow these easy steps to draw a cat the easiest way possible. In pencil, we're going to start with an oval with 2 circles at the bottom for the feet, then a little hump on the top for the back and the tail. Draw a couple triangles on the sides, kind of rounded on the top. Next, we start inking. Start with one ear, next ear, we'll do the back, the tail, the cheeks, left foot, right foot. Don't forget the toes. The nose should be a small little triangle with a W underneath. And the eyes should be kind of an upside down U. Don't forget the whiskers. Then we're gonna outline it a little thicker, add these little lines in the ears, and color in the nose. Don't forget to share with your friends, even if they're not artists. Anybody could draw this cute little kitty. Thanks for watching, guys. Use these 3 tips to make your eye drawings look a lot more realistic. Number 1, under the eyelid, you're going to create a very dark shadow. It should all be gray except for these 2 highlight spots. With this dark shadow, it's going to make it contrast against those white reflections and really make it pop. The bottom of the eye should be a little bit lighter. Number 2, pay close attention to the direction of the eyelashes. They should be thicker and heavier on the outside of the eye. And number 3, this is what's really going to make the difference. The whites of the eye shouldn't be white. Shade those in a little bit. And the most important part, the eyelashes should not be coming out of the eye. So if you leave a little white space there, then draw on your eyelashes, this will create the contour of the bottom eyelid. Leave this space white. Watch this very simple trick at creating super realistic eyebrows. This is an amazing trick and one of the easiest ones I know. After shading the basic shape of the eyebrow, use a dark pencil like a 6B to start adding the individual hairs and pay attention to the direction each hair is going. Now here's the best part. This is where the magic happens. Watch the direction of the pencil. You're almost gonna wanna crosshatch the hairs. This is gonna add the detail and make it look like the hairs are overlapping and create the contour and the shape to it. Now I'm gonna add a little more shading under the eyebrow. It's looking a little too light. I'm gonna add some more to the eyebrow itself. After this, repeat the first step, and remember, do that crosshatch on the top left.
That's the moneymaker.
Thanks for watching. Share with your artist friend.
How do you draw eyelashes? Let me show you. Here we go. Make sure you stay till the end so you can see how it turns out. The main thing is draw them going down, then curving up. Down and then curving up. Our eyelashes are there to protect our eyes. If they went straight up like I see a lot of people doing, our eyes wouldn't be very protected. And same thing goes for the front view. When looking at the eye from the front, you want the eyelashes to go down and then curve up. And you want them to be a little bit heavier on the outside. Down and then curve up. Try to space them randomly so they don't look too perfect. Make sure to pay attention to the direction of the eyelashes too. They should go to the outside, on the outside, and go kind of straight up when they're in the middle. Thanks for watching. Follow for more tips.